Hey y'all, my name is Link Frostmas, and today we're going to be taking a look at the Transformers Generations Combined Wars Deluxe Class Breakdown. And as his name suggests, Breakdown is always on the verge of a mental breakdown. This dude's got an extreme case of paranoia that makes him paranoid and skeptical of anything and everything, even inanimate objects, even his teammates. And this Deluxe was the one I was most excited to get into. Not because I like him, I actually hate this mold.
Let's tear him open a new one.
Starting with the robot mode. And let me talk about what I like first. I like the silver and the blue. The silver paint is applied really well, and the blue has a deep sheen to it that really makes it pop. This really brings to life that sculpted in detail in the chest. Wow. And that head?
Toe curling.
The helmet keeps the blue, so that's a plus. The white eyes are fantastic, and that red face creates such an awesome contrast to the overall sculpt. And with all of this combined, you can totally see the fear in his eyes.
Don't turn around. I'm always watching you.
And the last thing I like is... just kidding. That's it. I hate everything else. I like the color beige, but there's something about this beige on Breakdown that looks really cheap. Maybe it's the contrast of it being unpainted and everything else on him is painted, but it doesn't look good. These proportions are terrible too. He's not short, but somehow looks short and stubby. And the main culprit to this are his legs. His legs are terrible. First, whatever the fuck is going on with his hips is not helping him out. And I always hated this mechanism because I always felt I could never get his hips perfectly aligned. The thighs themselves are too skinny and too short. Like, his knee is too high up. The connection to the lower leg isn't as tight as I would like, and speaking of the lower leg, the skinny thigh compared to this really wide lower leg looks so off. Actually hurts. And that's not the end of it. When you look at his profile, you not only see his drooping backpack, but you also see how bad the leg profile looks, and that his head isn't aligned with his shoulders, and the back head-on isn't much prettier either. So, do you see what I mean? This guy does not look good. There are hints of greatness with the paint, the head, the chest, and quite frankly, impressive sculpted in detail, but literally everything else, especially the proportions, holds him back so much that I straight up do not like him. Yeah. Really, this guy can kiss my ass. It's kind of hairy, but it's prettier than him. And say what you will, there's nothing that will convince me that this guy looks good. Not even the accessories. I think it sucks that for a lame-ass figure, he has one of the cooler accessories. This gunblade. Seriously, I love this thing. It looks cool as a sword, and with the revolver chamber and long-ass barrel, can also be held as some sort of revolver rifle, a la Leon from Final Fantasy VIII. I don't know who this guy is, I only know him from the first Kingdom Hearts game. And his appendix weapon, yeah, looks goofy, but I actually really like the sculpted in detail, and the two big muzzles. I don't know, there's just something about it that makes it look cool. Cool enough that if you were to store it on his back, it actually doesn't look too bad. Just don't look at it from the profile. Even the included comic book depicts this, and as cool as the artwork is, the artists did their best, but you cannot make this figure look cool. Don't. So this is Combiner Wars number 5, actually Robots in Disguise 13. It's a good read, rest in peace IDW, that's his accessories. And as cool as they are, it's too bad that they aren't cool enough to distract you from this guy's articulation. Okay, the top half of this guy is alright, basic stuff. The problem comes out on this guy's lower half. The legs suck. They got basic leg movements down, but the shifting hips are annoying to deal with, and they're just so proportionally off that they look terrible. And because of how short his thighs are, any bending knee pose just looks stupid. So he does technically have passable articulation, but his overall look brings down any pose you get him in. And if Breakdown isn't paranoid about how he looks next to someone else, especially his mates, then, well,
he should be.
And that's his robot mode.
I don't like it.
Phew, feels good to say that. Simply put, he doesn't look like a cool Transformer. Sorry, buddy. Go cry about it.
But does he look cool as a car? Let's see.
Here's Breakdown's car mode. Now, I will say some things about it, but I will give it credit.
At least it's supposed to be a Lamborghini.
Well, a cross of a Lamborghini Diablo and a Code Zero to be exact. And, okay, let me just get what I like out of the way. It's sleek, it's cool. The red hood really pops, loving that. Props to the sculpted in mirrors, and the silver headlights are cool. And the tires. Man, they don't make tires like that anymore. Everything else? I don't hate.
But I don't like either.
For starters, that beige being the primary color is not ideal to me. Makes his whole body look cheap. It sucks that there's only so much of that red and that blue color throughout. So yeah, plus there isn't too much sculpted in detail. The spoiler looks kinda dinky actually. Is it just me? I don't know, I think it's too small. The solid black mirrors don't look amazing, but that 15 racing decal looks especially stupid and out of place.
I don't like it.
So this car is all right. What am I kidding? It's less than alright. But not bad. And props to Breakdown for this. There is actually proper integration with his appendix weapon. Tab in this piece of the back of the car, and there's two grooves here that fit into these notches. And not gonna lie, looks cool. It would be a lot better if it wasn't purple, but it is a natural integration, so again, props to that. And the gunblade, you can just put in his butt. I don't know. He's solid.
Doesn't roll too well, actually.
And a good size. In car mode with his mates, though, this is a whole other level of cool. He's my least favorite, but the Combiner Wars Stunticons are looking good so far. And with the classic crew all here, they're ready to stunt on everyone. So yeah, car mode. But we got two more modes left. I feel like the more we get through these, the more quicker these segments get. So let's go. First, arm mode. Arm mode. I will say, I like how the hood folds down and the resulting look, but he looks stubby, right? You see it? Am I crazy? Probably. Oh well. Arm mode, now leg mode. Leg mode. Nothing really to say. It's a leg. Yeah. That's it. Let's rate him. And I hope you're not surprised. I don't think he's terrible, but I do genuinely think that Combiner Wars Breakdown is, well, bad. Yeah, I genuinely think this guy is bad. I don't like his robot mode, and I'm really torn between thoughts regarding his car mode. The bad proportions are the root of many of his problems, severely hammering his look and how he feels. It's to the point where I don't want to play with him. If a toy isn't fun and doesn't look cool, then I think it's a bad toy. The car is fine, but it's severely overshadowed by literally anybody else. And well, I have given Combiner Wars Breakdown a lot of shit, but I will give him this.
At least he has his own separate mode.